Did you know that you could be a first-time home buyer in Canada more than once? It's true. So we're going to talk about what defines a first-time home buyer in Canada. But what about something like a condo or a strata? What's the difference when you're talking about the two? On this episode of Ball of Prairie Real Estate, I'm explaining real estate terminology that you need to know when you're buying a house in Canada. Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Bald Prairie Real Estate, where I educate you all about Canadian real estate. Now, if you're new here, my name is Matthew Fife. I'm a real estate agent in Regina, Saskatchewan. I like doing Canadian real estate market updates and educational videos like this. So if you're interested in anything that has to do with buying a house in Canada or just real estate in Canada in general, go ahead, hit the like and subscribe button right now so you don't miss any of my future videos. On this episode of Bald Prairie Real Estate, I'm gonna go walk through some terms or terminology that people use in real estate when they're buying a house or that real estate agents and mortgage brokers use all the time. And I'm explaining to you so you know what the heck they're talking about, because these are important terms you need to know when you are buying a house in Canada. But as always, we gotta start this off with another one of my terrible jokes. And again, this one comes from a viewer. I love viewer jokes. So if you've got great jokes, put those in the comments below right now. So, when is the best time to go to the dentist? When it's tooth hurty. Ooh, that's a rough one. Come on, somebody put a better joke in there. I love when you guys put those jokes in the comments. What is a first-time home buyer in Canada? Well, let's break that down. And we're gonna use the Canada Revenue Agency's definition of a first-time home buyer because it's used for income tax purposes. There is a small income tax rebate for first-time home buyers, as well any of the government programs for first-time homebuyers, be it the first-time homebuyer incentive program or the first-time homebuyer plan, which is where you can use your RSPs as your down payment. Those are all using the CRA definition of a first-time homebuyer in Canada. Their wording is fairly clear on it, but let's break it down. They say, and it's right on their website, that a first-time homebuyer is anyone who is purchasing your home who has not owned or lived in a home owned by themselves or a common law spouse in the year that they are purchasing or the four preceding years. So essentially, if you're not living the house that either you or your common law spouse own for five consecutive years, you are a first-time home buyer. And like I said in the intro, you could be a first-time home buyer twice, actually, maybe even three times. So let's go through an example. If you owned a home or you were living in a home with a common law partner and you split up and the house was sold, or you're just living in another home, you're renting one, after five consecutive years, you'll be considered a first-time home buyer again. So you could be a first-time home buyer multiple times in Canada. Sometimes people get confused that only first-time home buyers can put down 5%, and that is also not true as well. If you're buying a house in Canada and it's for your primary residence, you have to have a minimum of 5% down, even if you're not a first-time home buyer. So you've already bought a house, you're living in it, you're buying a second house. This is gonna be moving into this as your primary residence. So you're gonna be selling your first house, moving into this one. You can purchase that with 5% down. You don't need a 20% down payment for the next house. As long as it is owner occupied, it's gonna be your primary residence. You can purchase a home with 5% down, whether you're a first-time home buyer or not. Down payments versus deposits. They sound kind of similar. They are totally different, but yet they are interconnected. So let's chat about this here. When you're buying a house in Canada, you know you need at least a 5% down payment to even be qualified for a mortgage. So you have to at least 5% down. But when you are writing an offer, generally you're gonna have a deposit attached to that offers to show that you are serious about buying that house. Now that deposit goes into your buyer's brokerage trust account, and it only moves one of two ways. You either buy the house and it's part of your down payment, or you don't buy the house and then it gets refunded to you. But wait a second, that deposit was there to show that you're serious. It's 100% refundable. That doesn't really make a lot of sense for sellers. Well, that's because when you're making an offer, generally it's gonna be a conditional offer. And we're gonna get to conditional offers in just a second here. But if that house doesn't meet your conditions, then your deposit gets returned to you. But if you make an unconditional offer, and I'm gonna talk about those as well in a second, or you remove all the conditions after you have gone through your home inspection and got your financing approved, everything like that, if at that point, after you've removed conditions, you decide you're not gonna buy the house, or for whatever reason, you're unable to buy that house, then your deposit is in jeopardy. The sellers can claim that deposit you have put as part of the offer. So deposits, they're attached to offers, they're part of your down payment, and they're only in jeopardy once you remove conditions. But once you have, the sellers can claim that deposit. What are conditions and terms? They sound really similar, but they're actually completely different. Now hold on to this for a second, stick with me here. Conditions are something you're attaching to the offer. You're basically saying to the seller, I'll buy your house as long as it meets these conditions. So most offers when you're buying a house in Canada will be what's called a conditional offer because it's got to meet those conditions. So some of the conditions you're going to put on a home purchase is going to be your satisfactory financing, so making sure you get a mortgage approved, and things like inspection, so structural, you're going to be looking through the mechanical systems, all that type of stuff. If that home through that inspection period or the conditional period, as we will often call it, doesn't meet your conditions. So maybe you find a significant structural problem in the home and you don't want to buy the house anymore. You can collapse the deal. You're only out the cost of your inspections. The deposit that you put on that offer on that house is refundable to you until you remove conditions. But if you do remove conditions and then you decide you don't want to buy the house, or you're going to back out of the deal for whatever reason, maybe you can't get your financing even though you thought you had it in place, the deposit you put with that offer is now going to belong to the seller. So make sure when you are moving conditions, you're 100% satisfied, because at that point your deposit becomes in jeopardy. What are terms then? So terms are additional items being added to the contract to purchase and sale when you're buying a house. What the heck does that mean? Okay, hold up here. Let's go through an example. You're buying a brand new house in Canada. It's the middle of winter and they cannot pour the driveway. It's too cold. So you would put a term to that deal that would say, okay, sellers, you have to complete that driveway prior to July 31st, for example. And until you complete that, I, as the buyer in a trust account, I'm gonna withhold $8,000 of the purchase price until that's completed. If the sellers do not complete that driveway before July 31st, then you, the buyer, would get that $8,000 back. As soon as the driveway is completed, then the sellers get that $8,000 released from the trust account. So terms and conditions. Conditions, you're saying, I'll buy your house as long as it meets this criteria. Terms are additional items that have to happen as part of the contract to purchase and sale. Depending where you're from in Canada, you've probably heard the word condo or strata, and you're wondering, what the heck? You've heard both these words, what do they mean? Well, they're the exact same thing. Condos and stratas are just a different word for a type of ownership, and that's the key word here, is ownership. A lot of people, when they think of condos, they're thinking of the apartment buildings and the high-rise buildings in Toronto, Vancouver, Montreal, big centers. The word condo denotes ownership, not a style of building. So you can have a condo in a lot of different types of buildings. You have single family homes all in one cul-de-sac, where the condo corporation is responsible for maybe the street maintenance and some of the landscaping. You can have townhouses. They're responsible for all the exterior of the property. You're responsible for the interior. They do the landscaping. Maybe some utilities are included. Or what most people commonly think of, the apartment high-rises, where most or all your utilities are included, the whole building is maintained, and you've got like common space like pools or a common area space. But condos, that condominium word, denotes a style of ownership, not a style of building. Earlier in the video, we talked about conditional offers and terms. Well, an unconditional offer, you probably already got it figured out, is when you're writing an offer with zero conditions attached to it. You're essentially saying to the sellers, here's our offer, here's what we're willing to pay you to buy your house today. There are some advantages to this, and of course, some very significant pitfalls. In these really hot Canadian real estate markets, where they're seeing multiple offers on a lot of different houses, the conditional offers the sellers receive, they're just chucking them out. They're probably not even looking at them if they've got a number of unconditional offers. The seller's benefit to that is they don't have to worry about the buyers achieving their financing or any problems during home inspections, because the buyers aren't doing any of that. So if you're writing an unconditional offer, you have to be 100% satisfied when you write that offer that this is the house for you, and you know that house inside and out. Because when you write that offer and you have that deposit on it, that deposit is immediately in jeopardy because there are no conditions to that offer. So if you walk away from that deal, your deposit is gone. The biggest challenge you've got to make sure is that your financing is 100% in order, because if for whatever reason you can't get your financing, again, that deposit is gone. So you need to know that you're approved or you have a backup plan in case something happens. You're also going to need to have a backup plan if the bank during your financing process calls for an appraisal and maybe the appraisal value comes in lower than your agreed upon price. You need to be able to cover that difference for that home purchase, or you're gonna have to walk away from that deal and lose your deposit. Home inspections, you obviously can't do them if you're writing an unconditional offer. I've seen buyers where they are bringing home inspectors through on second showings to kind of do a once over, but that's not really a thorough home inspection. So when you're buying a house with an unconditional offer in Canada, make sure you're 100% satisfied, because your deposit could be gone if you walk away from that deal. So be 100% sure you're happy with the house and the whole deal, the price, and your mortgage approval process, everything, before you write an unconditional offer. There's just a few more terms that you need to know when you are buying a house in Canada. If you want me to explain some future real estate terminology, or if you've heard terms that mortgage brokers or real estate agents, or even just in the news, you've heard terminology you'd like me to explain, let me know in the comments below and I will get through those. If you are a first-time home buyer and you've got questions, perfect. I have a video series right here dedicated to first-time home buyers. If you want to learn about real estate in Canada in 2 minutes or less, right here, I call it 2 Minute Tuesday, where I cover one topic in 2 minutes or less. Check those out. As always, guys, thanks very much for watching.